Every debugging session starts with a program that failed and which we need to debug. For this purpose, let's build a simple program that we're going to use as an ongoing example. The idea is to write a function that takes an HTML input, that is, text together with HTML markup, and returns just the text. For instance, if the input is HTML markup for bold, followed by a text foo, followed by HTML markup for end of bold, then we want to return just the text. Anything that is within these angle brackets should be stripped away. How do we do this? A simple way is to process the HTML input character by character and distinguish two modes. When we are in tag mode, we ignore all input. When we are in non-tag mode, we add all input to the output. And we switch between these modes, tag and non-tag, by looking at these angle brackets in here. When we see the beginning of an HTML markup, as you can see in this less than sign, we enter tag mode. When we see the end of an HTML markup, that is a greater sign, we exit tag mode. We can describe the behavior of our function as a finite state machine with two states, non-tag mode, that is, we're processing text, and tag mode, that is, we're ignoring HTML markup. When we see a less than sign, we go into tag mode. When we see a greater than sign, we exit tag mode. For all other inputs, we stay in the same states. When we are in non-tag mode and see any character that's not the beginning of an HTML markup, we add this character to the output. Whereas in tag mode, we simply ignore the HTML markup that we process in here. So when we are processing this HTML input, initially we're in non-tag mode. Now we see the beginning of an HTML markup. We go into tag mode. We see the B, which is not the end of a tag. Then we get the end of the tag, go back into non-tag mode, see the F, add this, see the O, add this, see the O, add this again. So our output now is FOO. And now again, we see the beginning of a tag where we process, or more specifically, where we ignore all characters up to the closing tag. And then our output is indeed the text inside the HTML markup.